This is my true love.
Viola and Marcus Johnson seemed like a good match from the moment they met.
And I asked her for a phone number, and she was like, she gave me the number, and she's like, call me tomorrow. So I was like, well, I gotta call you tomorrow. So we can't talk today.
3 years later, they're married and still deep in conversation.
You cheating already because you missed this spot.
Whether they're playing games.
That's it too.
Or attending them. You almost always see them in matching shirts.
We went to a comedy show last night for Valentine's Day.
But the good times hit a bump when Marcus went to the doctor for a routine checkup and left with a troubling diagnosis.
You know, they tell me that my kidneys are failing. This may not be a relationship that you want to get into with a sick person.
And I'm like, no, we're going to beat this. Don't even worry about it. We got this.
Soon, Marcus was bloated, exhausted, and resigned to the fact that he might not make it.
And then all of a sudden, my health just took a drastic change to where I couldn't even swallow air without throwing up.
He gained weight and retained fluid. He had to leave his job as a newspaper writer.
It was almost feeling like I was drowning while I was talking.
Viola is a registered nurse and saw the situation getting worse.
I knew that it was bad because I knew, you know, fluid could fill up in his lungs. He could be laying down and just stop breathing.
Marcus was on dialysis for 9 hours a day. He says he didn't want to ask relatives to donate a kidney.
It's not an easy thing to ask your brothers or, you know, a family member to get tested to give you a kidney. It's not like asking to borrow $10. So I just refused to ask anybody, and I was like, well, I'll just live the rest of my life either on dialysis or it's, you know, it is what it is.
Viola insisted that she would get tested, even though doctors told them that of the more than 10,000 kidney transplants each year, fewer than 1% were between unrelated living people, and even fewer than that between actual spouses. But Viola's test results came back as she was getting her nails done.
She called and she said, you're the match. You're the perfect match. And I just started screaming. So all the nail techs, they're looking around like, what's wrong? And I'm like, I'm the match. I'm the match.
For my wife to be the match, that's really rare.
Kidney failure was no match for this match.
I tell them, like, we were destined to be, like, God knows everybody has a purpose. And people may not realize it, but my purpose was to actually help save his life.
Now, the surgery is set for this Thursday at UIC Medical Center, and they say once they get out of surgery, they will have plenty of help because normally it's one spouse taking care of the other after they got out of surgery. They're both going to be recovering, but they've got family to come.
That's good. Oh, yeah. I love that story.
Yeah, it's I'm the match, and really, it means so much.
Really cool.
You know they'll have some new T-shirts made after this experience.
Definitely.
For sure. All right. Thanks.